Hi guys! Salamat sa inyong patuloy na pagsubaybay dito sa ating ginagawang discussions about mechanics of deformable bodies. In today's discussion, we shall have a sample problem on how do we compute for stresses caused by an external load upon a member of a structure. And here is our problem, guys. The vertical truss shown in the figure is subjected to vertical load P. The cross-sectional area of each member in millimeter square and the maximum allowable stresses in tension and in compression are shown in the table. Determine the maximum safe vertical load P that can be applied at C. Which member is the most critical part of the structure? Bago natin solvin ang problem, guys, ay i-analyze natin muna mabuti itong ating problem. So makikita sa illustration na meron tayo ditong simple truss na kung saan ang dimensions ay ang sumusunod. Itong member BC ay 3 meters, the member AC is 4 meters, and the member AB is 5 meters. There is a vertical load P acting at C. And the properties of the materials are indicated in this table. So that for AB, you have the cross-sectional area of 300, the maximum stress in tension of 140, maximum stress in compression of 300. Same is true with member AC and BC. They are given different cross-sectional area, different maximum stress in tension and in compression. So mapapansin na dahil iba't iba yung kanyang maximum stress in tension and in compression ay iba't ibang materials itong bumubuo sa ating truss. And in this problem, we are required which of the material is the most critical and how much is the maximum value of the safe load P that can be applied here. Pag sinabi natin maximum safe load, yun yung maximum na hindi o na walang material na masisira or mag-i-exceed sa kanyang maximum allowable stress. If it is subjected to tension, then the maximum allowable stress in tension is whatever is given in the table. So, to solve the problem, you will note that the dimension of the truss is in the ratio of 3, 4, and 5. So lumalabas that the truss is in the form of a right triangle having the side AB as the hypotenuse. And as such, this angle C, is our right angle. And if we will consider this angle A as angle theta, and this angle B as angle beta, then the function of theta and beta can be expressed using the sides of the triangle representing the dimensions of each member of the truss. And therefore, we expect that sine of theta, which is also the same as cosine of beta, because theta and beta are complementary angles, and this is equal to the ratio of 3 over 5. Similarly, we can compute for sine of beta, which is also the same as the cosine of beta, and this is the ratio of 4 over 5, and that is equal to 0.8. In order for us to solve for the maximum safe load P, we need to compute for the actual load that is acting on member AC, BC, and AB, and then we divide it with the area and equate it with whatever is the maximum stresses either in tension or in compression for us to be able to get the maximum safe load P. And so if we're going to solve for the forces acting on each member of the truss using any appropriate method of analysis, and in this case it would be good to consider using method of joint. And we can start our analysis using method of joint at joint C. And you will notice that Even without computing for the reaction at the support, we can start analyzing the structure because there is a point or a joint where only two unknown members are acting, and this is at joint C. So if we're going to isolate joint C here, we show the forces acting at joint C. We have the force P. We have the axial load acting on AC, which is assumed to be in the form of a compression. We also have the force exerted by the member BC, which is also in the form of compression, and that you have the force, and here is our BC. Assuming that we consider here a horizontal reference axis in order for us to define the direction of AC and BC, so that if we will extend the direction of AC and we consider it as our x-axis, then the vertical perpendicular axis to x-axis, which is the extension of the direction of the force BC, can be considered as our y-axis. And because AC here is making an angle of theta with respect to the horizontal, therefore this angle will also be equal to angle theta. Therefore, the angle that this P is making with respect to the x-axis will be equal to the angle beta, because theta and beta are complementary angles. And as such, if we would like to compute for the force acting on member AC, then we apply the summation of force along x-axis and treat that the direction of the force in the upward direction to the right be positive, then our equation will become equal to AC minus the x component of P, which is equal to P cosine of beta, shall be equal to zero. Now, if we are going to substitute the value of the cosine of beta, which is equal to 0.6 here, therefore our equation will become equal to, and then we transpose this to the right hand side of the equation, then our equation becomes equal to AC shall be equal to P multiplied by cosine of beta, which is 0.6, or simply this becomes equal to AC equal to 0.6P, which is in compression. Furthermore, if we shall be summing of forces in the direction of the y-axis equal to zero, we can solve for the value of the force acting on member BC. And if we will be assuming that the force directed in this direction be positive, then our equation will become equal to BC minus the y component of P equal to zero, where the y component of P is equal to P sine of beta. Now, if sine of beta is substituted with this value, which is equal to 0.8, therefore BC will be equal to 0.8 of P, and that is shall be equal to compression, because BC is directed in towards the joint. Now, if we're going to isolate joint B as FBD, this one, then we can solve for the value of the force acting on member AB. Now, if you will be isolating it as FBD, then we have this as our joint B. The force exerted by member BC is in the form of compression. Therefore, if it is to be shown to be acting at point joint B, therefore it must be directed towards B, and it should be shown to be directed in that direction. Furthermore, there is a resultant exerted by the floor upon B. Therefore, that resultant shall be drawn in that direction. And this will be our R sub 1. Similarly, the force exerted by the member AB, which may be assumed to be directed to the left because of the rightward component of BC. Therefore, this should be directed to the left when drawn at point B. And the angle that this BC, with respect to the direction of the line AB, shall be equal to beta. Therefore, we can solve for the force exerted by the member AB by summing of forces horizontal equal to zero. so that if we will assume that rightward direction be positive, therefore our equation becomes BC cosine of beta minus AB shall be equal to zero. If BC, which is equal to 0.8, is substituted here, as well as the magnitude of the cosine of beta, which is equal to 0.6, therefore our equation will become equal to 0.8 of B multiplied by 0.6 minus AB shall be equal to zero. And then simplifying this equation, we can solve for AB, and that AB is equal to 0.48 of P, which is in the form of a tension. Now, if you are going to summarize the forces acting on each member of the truss, we have here the force acting or exerted by the member AB, which is equal to 0.48 of P, which is in the form of tension. We also have here the force exerted by AC, which is 0.6 of P, which is in compression. And then if we will be moving it here so that we can summarize it there, so we have AC equal to 0.6 of P. Similarly, the force exerted by BC, which is equal to 0.8 of P, that is in compression, may be moved somewhere here, so that we now have summarized our forces. Now, going back to the property of the members, that the property of the members are that the member AB has a cross-sectional area of 300, and because it is subjected to tension, therefore the maximum allowable stress shall be equal to 140, and such that the maximum permissible stress in the member AB, because it is in tension, shall be equal to 140. Similarly, for AC, which is subjected to compression, its maximum permissible stress is 250, as indicated in the table. Furthermore, the maximum stress in BC shall be equal to 240 because it is subjected to compression, and as indicated in the table, its maximum stress is only 240. Now, after we have taken the maximum permissible stress in each of the material, we can substitute these values in the formula for stress for us to be able to solve for the maximum safe load P. So that for the member AB, which is subjected to tension and whose area is 300 square millimeter, its maximum permissible stress is 140, and the actual load, or the load causing stress, is expressed in terms of P, which is equal to 0.48. So that if this will be substituted in the formula for stress, stress of AB, which is equal to P of AB divided by area of AB, then substituting the values, so that for stress of 140, for P of AB, which is equal to 0.48, and area of AB, which is equal to 300, is substituted or are substituted, then our equation becomes equal to 140 megapascal is equivalent to newton per square millimeter, which is equal to 0.48 of P, and that is our P of AB, divided by the cross-sectional area, that is equal to 300 square millimeter. The square millimeter will both cancel each other, and that from here, we can solve for the value of P, which is equal to 87,500 newton, or equivalent to 87.5 kilonewton. For member BAC, which is subjected to compression and whose permissible stress is only 250 megapascal, it is subjected to an axial load of 0.6 P, and whose cross-sectional area is 200. If this shall be substituted in this formula, that stress is equal to P of AC divided by area of AC, therefore the equation becomes equal to 200 newton per square millimeter shall be equal to 0.6 of P divided by 200 square millimeter, and from here millimeter square will cancel, so that we can solve for the value of P, that is equal to 83,333 newton, or 83.33 kilonewton. Furthermore, for the member BC, which is subjected to compression, the permissible stress is 240. Its actual load, or the force acting on this member, is equivalent to 0.8 of P, where the cross-sectional area of BC is given to be 275. If all of these values are substituted In the stress formula, that stress is equal to P of BC over area of BC. Therefore, our equation becomes equal to 240 N per square millimeter shall be equal to 0.8 of P divided by 275. So that when square millimeter will cancel, we can solve for the value of P, which is equal to 82,500 N or equivalent to 82.5 kN. Now, after we have computed for the values of the P that each of the member are subjected, the question is, how are we going to give our final answer, since we are asked to determine the maximum safe load P? To explain how are we going to give our answer, let us try to imagine that going back to our original thrust, and let us try to assume that P will be given a value, that will increase from zero until such time that one of the member has reached its maximum stress. If P shall be given an increasing value, and that it reaches a value of 82.5 kN, then the member BC will be stressed to its maximum stress of 240. If it will be increased further, greater than 82.5, you will notice that the stress on member BC will already be more than 240. And at that time, if it is already more than 240, then it will already fail. And once it failed, it cannot, the other member of the structure cannot anymore hold, and support the value of P. As such, one member was already reached the maximum stress. The other member cannot anymore continue to support the stress. And therefore, it is this member BC that would be considered as the most critical, and the value of P shall be the value of 82.5 kN. And therefore, we can make conclusion that the maximum safe vertical load is 82.5 kN and is controlled by the member BC, which is considered to be the most critical member of the truss. Sana guys ay nasundan ninyo ang ginawa natin presentation, at sana ay patuloy ninyo subaybayan itong ating ginagawang discussions by subscribing to this channel. And if you have friends na sa tingin mo ay mangangailangan din ng ganitong discussions, ay i-share natin itong ating channel para naman sila ay ma-inform din of my future uploads. Guys, thank you very much for watching.